Hi, I'm Bowling Otter.
And I'm Missy Sandwich.
And welcome to
the BS on the Internet.
Well, it's been another one of those weeks.
Has it?
Yes!
It always has.
Yes, it always has.
A lot. You know what?
It always has been a week.
You know what messed me up this week?
What?
April 1st, because it was April Fool's Day.
Yes.
That is a weird day. And this is the first year in a while, really, I think in my whole life, where everybody was like, they were not in the mood.
Yeah, all Twitter was just like, nah.
Yeah, they were just,
like, everybody
mess
just
with
stop.
Me today.
Like, don't do this year.
And you know what, though? I'm not a big fan of like mean spirited pranks.
Yeah.
You know, like, there's a lot of. Are you yawning?
No. What happened?
You made a yawn face like you were. Are you tired?
I made a yawn face. I am tired, but.
We're tired. We had a really busy day. It's Saturday.
Yes.
We usually record this on Friday. I had a bridal shower to go to today. Mm-hmm. And you went to go see your parents. It was a very, very long day. So we're very, very tired. So
yes.
If you were yawning, I would say, I understand.
Oh, okay.
That's what I was going to say.
All right.
But it's. What were we even talking about? Oh! Pranks! Mean-spirited pranks. But then, like, you know how you have, like, the fake pregnancy pranks?
Yep.
Justin Bieber did that. They faked a pregnancy.
Mm-hmm.
Or some. I've always hated the fake lottery tickets.
Yeah.
Making people feel like they won the lottery or something like that. You know, I always thought that was so mean. And I think people are kind of over it.
More or less, I think.
Right now?
Yeah, it didn't seem like a big. I like that. Marquez Brownlee had a pretty funny.
He did.
Video with like
that
the Pixel 4 Ultra, whatever it was, which is kind of like, okay.
But you know what? With Marquez Brownlee, like, I trust him. And I was watching, and we're watching that video. If you guys don't know what we're talking about, he put up a video saying that he had like a leak
for the Pixel 4. Right. Yeah, but I mean, right off the bat, it was like pretty obvious. Like,
but he's so like dependable.
Yeah, but it was April 1st.
I know. And I'm like,
to know.
Okay. But I
that
don't know.
And halfway through the video was literally wearing a tinfoil hat.
Oh, right. Yeah. By the halfway point, I was like, okay. I got it.
I was like, you know, I'm like, yes, April Fool's. And Lizzie's like, I don't know. You think he actually got this? I'm like, this has got to be April Fool's. Like, I don't know. I think maybe. But. And we're like looking at the concept of this Pixel 4, and it looks like a giant case with this crazy wedge sticking out on top. And it's like, there's no way. That's the phone.
Never know with tech. I'm just saying. But
Google
it was,
made the worst
yeah, not
ever.
A lot of people were in the mood. I tweeted a little while ago, one April Fool's, I kind of went for Maddie and he just was not having it.
No.
No. One year I sewed all of his underwear together.
Yes.
You just pulled off a piece and went about your business. I found, it came up off, like on my time hop on my phone. I forgot I glued, that same day, I hot glued together your shampoo and your body wash. And put it in the shower. And you didn't say anything. And you just like pulled it apart and came out just foiled all of it. Just
never mentioned anything. I just came out of the shower.
No, like, I think I remember this. And I think I remember hearing you go like, huh. In the shower. And that's it. And then you come out of the shower and I'm like, and you had a towel on and you're going through your underwear. And I'm like, and you just kind of went like, you know, and then like ripped them apart. Really just foiled. Not good. So I
remember looking at them thinking like, oh, maybe they got tangled up in the dryer or something. So I'll just, you know, whatever. Okay, I'll put on my underwear.
Oh, my God. I just took like one, like a needle and thread, and a long piece of thread, and just like threaded them all together, like in a big string, and then tied it off and was like, hoo-hoo-hoo. And then I had to be the one to be like, did you notice? Did you see? Did you know?
What did I say? Do you remember?
You went like, oh. Oh, so that was, okay. And I was like, ugh, all right. I know. So now I know to not do this stuff. But if you did anything interesting for April Fool's, put it in the comments.
I'm sorry I didn't give you your satisfying reaction for that.
I know. I can't even scare you at all.
You scare me sometimes. You've done it a few times.
Ugh.
You've done it a few times.
I know. Or sometimes I'll come around a corner and I'll be like, ha!
Yeah.
And he'll just, one time I tried to scare him and his mom at the same time, coming up the steps, and both of them just. And I was like, oh,
you,
really?
On the other hand, get scared literally if I just walk into the room.
Yeah, I
don't even do anything. So walk here, it's like, ah! I'm like, what? I just walked in.
I startle really, really easy. I know. But anyway. We have things to talk about.
Yes.
Okay, so this story was going around this week. We were recording, and we got a breaking news alert on our phone saying that there was this guy that showed up at a woman's car. She was in a parking lot, knocked on her window, and said he was a missing child who had since grown, and he had escaped some kidnappers and had been in captivity for years.
Six years.
Yeah, he said he was...
Eight years.
Right.
Eight years.
He said that he was Timothy Pitson, who disappeared in 2011 when he was 6 years old. And what had happened was his mother had checked him out of school when he was 6 years old. They went to a water park. They had like a couple of days of fun. And the mother wound up committing suicide, and very, very sad. And in her suicide note, she said, "Timothy is with people who love him. You will never find him." So the boy's father and the rest of his family have been, he's a missing child. Like, I can't even imagine the heartache, the pain or whatever. So we're like, oh my gosh. So we see this breaking news alert, you know, man, and he was beaten up, I think. He said he was in pain. He was all scratched up and everything. Said that he had escaped from a motel, ran across a bridge. He didn't know where he was. And, you know, he was in captivity all these years. So we're like, oh my gosh, what a crazy story. Like, can you imagine if he had been alive all this time in captivity? Is he okay? You know, and we're talking about it and everything. We're cleaning up from recording and we're like, oh my gosh, I can't believe it. So it turns out that it was a lie.
Yes, not actually him.
And it was a guy who, a 23-year-old man, so Timothy Pitson, the missing boy, would have been 14.
Yeah.
And this is the guy, he's 23, and he had just gotten out of prison for, I think, burglary or something, half a year and a half for burglary and vandalism. And he was released and supposed to start parole supervision for 3 years. So they gave the guy a DNA test to see if he was really Timothy Pitson, and he was not. The family is devastated.
Yeah, they thought he was back.
All over again.
Yeah.
And he, I mean, I could see, like, a resemblance.
Yeah, I mean, it wouldn't be completely insane. I mean, like, that picture, not so much. I mean, like, he looks older than 14 there.
I know.
Look, I mean, look at the facial hair and everything like that. He's like, but it wouldn't have been completely, I mean, I don't know. It's
so
just so
cool.
Terrible. Because I remember I heard about this, like, it came up on Twitter. It was trending.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh my God, Jeremy Pitson just came back.
Yeah,
like,
Timothy Pitson,
just came back. And like, and I remember, like, we're looking at it, like, oh my God, he's back. This is insane. I wonder what happened. And then it was like the next day, Lissy's like, hey, I looked into that. It's not actually him. It's like, oh my God. Like, the family had to have been so excited that he was back and that they were going to be able to walk him back into the family. And then all over again, they had to like live through losing
loss.
Him again.
Yeah.
And like,
I know.
It's crazy.
But then, like, obviously this is a sick person.
Yes.
Why would you do that?
Yeah.
And I just saw, because we were thinking about doing this for BS on the Internet, and I was like, well, why? I have so many questions, like so many other people do. Why would you do that? But they said that an old rerun of 2020 about Timothy Pitson came on a couple of weeks ago.
Oh.
So they think he watched it.
Okay.
And got his story and then just decided to...
That he would be Timothy Pitson?
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
But now they think it's federal charges. Throw him back in there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's so like...
And apparently, I think, didn't you mention that he had done this before or something? That he had like... pretended to be somebody else before?
Oh, I don't know. Oh, they talked to the family of this guy. The guy's name is Brian Reaney, or Reaney, I guess. 8 years in federal prison for doing this. But they talked to the guy's family, and the family said he is complete trouble. He had impersonated his brother during a traffic stop. They asked his name, he was speeding or something, and he gave his brother's name, and his brother got a letter in the mail saying his license was suspended. Huh. And he's like, what the heck? And found out that his brother used his name and said, like, oh yeah, you know, whatever. But the fact that, I mean, I feel like this is somebody who's ill.
He's ill.
Clearly ill.
Yeah.
But they're like
he may go to federal prison. I have a feeling he may end up in a hospital.
Yeah.
You know?
Like over here, imposter's brother, he's a terrible person.
Yeah.
Like,
he may end
up
just in a psychiatric facility. You know?
I know. Isn't that just like, wow.
Yeah, it's messed up.
Like,
to put that family
sank.
Through it all over again.
I know. Like, what did he think? Like, maybe he just didn't have the forethought to think how it would pan out. Did he think he would be, like, did he want a family? Did he not think that he would be tested?
I mean, if he's undiagnosed something, I suppose it depends on what he'd be diagnosed
with.
Well,
a lot of people who are in prison do have an undiagnosed mental illness or a diagnosed mental illness. A lot of people who have a mental illness wind up in prison.
Yeah.
You know?
place which isn't even really appropriate for
no,
them.
No, absolutely yeah, not. No, no. But it's, I just, all the way around, it's just, it's such like a yucky story. I'm sorry to start off with this.
Yeah, this is going to kick things off feeling great about
life.
We've
been following it all week because it was like, it went from a high to like a low.
Yeah, it was excitement at first. Yeah, you know?
we were like, oh my God, he got out.
Like he was kidnapped and he got out.
But, I know. But oh my gosh, crazy, right? Crazy.
Yeah. All right, this one I have very conflicting feelings about.
Yes.
All right, so there's a... There's an artist by the name of Lil Nas X. It kills me there's another Lil, okay? How many freaking
enough
Lils?
Enough
with the Lils. But there's another Lil, and he made a country song called Old Town Road.
Right.
And it entered in on the country charts at what, 20-something, 20?
19,
okay. So that's pretty high to enter in on the charts, right?
Right.
And from a guy that I hadn't heard of before. And it got removed from the country charts.
Right.
Because they said it wasn't a country song and it wasn't supposed to
now,
be on
there. It's on my Spotify down here if you want to click my Spotify.
Yes.
Because all of these episodes, surprise, they get claimed all the time anyway.
Yes, totally.
So we're going to listen to the song while we're talking about this.
Yes. Okay, so let's pump it up, Lissy.
So the idea that they said that it wasn't country.
Yeah.
I hear a banjo.
There's a banjo.
Talks about a horse. It sounds like a country song to me.
But then trap.
But then trap. Right.
I mean, he's not rapping.
No.
Not really, but this is kind of like where trap rap is now, sort of.
Yeah. But it entered into the country charts.
In the country charts, yes.
And I could see why people who are country fans would think that this was a country song.
Yes.
So, right?
I suppose. I'm so conflicted about this because when I first heard this, after I heard about this, I'm like, no, it's not a country song. It's a trap song. That's pop. You know, that's rap.
You don't think this is crossover?
Well, I'm coming along more and more. Like, as time goes on, I'm kind of like, well, you get to the point where you really have to break down what makes a country song, right? And like,
right.
And we kind of had this conversation a little bit earlier with some other stuff too, because country itself as a genre,
yeah,
that's basically the end of the song, right? So I'll stop it here.
Okay.
But it's a pretty short song, but country itself, it's like finally going through a bit of a. Like, it's developing, it's evolving,
it
it's becoming something new.
It is.
For the first time since, like, 90s Garth Brooks. Like, where it's been same thing for decades, and that's why I'd never been able to listen to it.
Right, right, right.
Unless it was, like, you know, really old stuff, you know?
Oh, right,
and, like,
right.
Which there's some really, like, classic stuff that's really cool.
You're talking about, like, Johnny Cash. Don
yeah, Johnny
Hartman
Cash, like, there's
guys.
Some great stuff back there,
yeah,
and, like, some amazing guitar playing.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
It was some old country. And then, like, Garth Brooks happened in the 90s, and then everything was Garth Brooks for, like,
George
three
Strait
decades.
And all
yeah,
that
it's like, oh,
stuff.
My God.
Yeah.
I gotta,
and it's just not our thing.
Yeah, I can't hear any more songs about blue jeans. Couldn't do it anymore.
And pick up trucks and your beer and all that. So,
but then
yeah,
you had, like, Casey Musgrave came out.
Yeah,
who was the dude that did the song with Justin Timberlake?
Chris Stapleton.
Chris Stapleton. And
right.
It was like, oh, there's
yeah,
some
there's
different
like
stuff
happening. Yeah.
And I remember hearing a couple songs. I'm like, wait, I'm not like totally averse to this. Maybe there's some cool
right.
things going on.
Right, right.
And then I'm kind of like, all right, like this comes out. And it's like, maybe it's time for the genre to be open to some different stuff. Because they've been in such a rut for such a long time.
Yeah, yeah.
But then the biggest problem here was that this entered in the charts, okay? And then Billboard removed it.
Right.
Straight up tore it out.
Right.
And it's like, well, how'd it get in there in the first place then?
They said they removed it for not embracing enough elements of today's country music in its current version.
Okay.
So, see, I feel like you could make an argument both ways for this.
Yeah.
You know, like, it has enough elements in it where you could kind of like, so it has the lyrical content.
Yeah.
It has a banjo if you're going to talk about instrumentation.
Instrumentation.
Yeah.
It's just
sure.
a trap beat. It's really
yeah,
just a trap beat.
It's just the trap beat
yeah.
in it. Yeah.
Because they're calling it country rap hit. And like,
yeah.
I guess where I was at odds with this when I first heard it was I felt like it was a country inspired rap song, but it was a rap song, not a country song. Just like you could have like inspiration into different genres, but it's still that genre.
But he didn't rap.
He kind of did. He rapped like Post Malone raps, right?
Oh, I mean, like, yeah.
It's basically where rap is
I
now.
I see what you're saying.
You know?
Yeah, for sure. Sure.
It's rap is
G-wagon,
really.
G-wagon. It's been in my head for weeks.
Right.
Wow.
Take a poopa. Wow.
Yeah,
sorry.
Exactly.
All right. Never mind. Not even going to go into that. But anyway, Billy Ray Cyrus actually did a remix
yes.
of this.
Now,
so he's
down.
Achy Breaky Heart Guy, if you don't know.
Look at look at this. All right. So it says Billy Ray Cyrus heard about this.
Yeah.
And decided to remix so he could get back on the charts.
Yeah, he endorsed it.
So he said, I was thinking, what's not country about it? What's the rudimentary element of a country and western song? Then I thought, it's honest, humble, has an infectious hook and a banjo. What the hell more do you need?
Oh, yeah. Another prominent player in the country music scene, John Rich, said that fans should decide whether the song is legit or not.
I haven't heard the remix. If you don't mind popping that on.
Let's pop over the remix.
Look at the horses in the...
I promise it's country. Look, there's horses.
Look at the horses in it.
All right.
But I
here.
Feel like. So did he just add a.
Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse to the
this is a country song.
Road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
I got the horses in.
Oh, so he basically gave it the hook.
Gave it the hook.
He basically sang the hook.
Yeah. So
it's so almost it's so difficult. I mean,
well, you know what, there have been crossover things, like remember that song, I hated it at the time, the song with Nelly and Tim McGraw, that over and over again,
over and
over
again,
over and over again.
Yeah,
that I believe was on both charts.
I do.
I think Sheryl Crow did one as well, but I know that a lot of people are thinking that there's racism involved here.
I mean, this is an argument
you know,
for that.
There
you know?
Would be, and there are black country artists. I know Darius Rucker has gone country.
Yeah.
As well, like that. This
Hootie.
Isn't
Hootie the Blowfish.
Yeah. Hootie. This is not unusual anymore. I mean, it's. I think it is still unusual to have any kind of people of color in the country scene, really, but they're there.
They're there.
I think it's still predominantly white, but I'm not that familiar with the genre as is because it's not really my thing.
Yeah, but it was interesting to have like Billy Ray Cyrus come in here do this because then it kind of gets like what a country music fan is going to tell Billy Ray Cyrus that he's not doing a country song. Like,
yeah.
Like he is a guy that can definitely give it clout.
Yeah,
and he's got a history.
I can make it legit for you.
He's got a history in the genre, in the business, you know, representing country music for sure. So it's like, I don't know.
I think it deserves to be there.
I think I'm at the point now where, I mean, country music is at a point where it's time to embrace some different looks.
Yeah.
You know, like guys,
and I think
like
they're ready.
This has gotten stale and like there's people that want to get in there and stir it up, change it up, try some different stuff.
Yeah.
Breathe new life into the genre.
Right.
Maybe like, and so I think embracing stuff like this is really a way to do that, you know?
And also like there's some, like with, I don't know if you guys have heard the Kacey Musgraves album that came out, it won best album.
That was almost like Americana.
I was just going to say that. Yeah. It was kind of like Americana country or whatever. We listened to it and it's
no
got some
no steel guitar. I was like, yes, no fiddles really. Like, I mean.
It's got some lovely songs on it. There are some country songs, not to say that, you know, I don't want to sound like we're crapping on country because we're really
not typically fans of country music.
It's just not that
not saying country music is bad. Just
no.
Doesn't sit within our preferences, right?
At least how it is in its popular state or how it was. I remember that, oh gosh, what was that Carrie Underwood song? Oh my gosh, Before He Cheats was so good. I broke my key into the side. That song was great.
And we also had that whole pop crossover with what's her face? I always forget her name. That did like, they had like 100 hits all at once and then kind of dropped off the face of the planet. Shania Twain. And she
Taylor
was like, Taylor Swift started with country.
Yeah. They're all popping around a little bit.
Yeah, there's a little bit more hopping back and forth. Yeah.
I feel like this was the next logical step.
Yeah.
But I was surprised to have seen them have removed it so quickly. They were like, no.
Yeah, no. We can't have this trap music in our country charts. That's basically what it felt like. But I bet to say my initial visceral reaction was like, that's not a country song.
Right.
Like, it's a trap song. Like, it may be country inspired, but it's a trap song. It's just pop. Mm-hmm. But then, you know, the more I thought about it, I'm like, what is telling you you can't have a trap beat in country?
Yeah.
You can have a trap beat in pretty much every other genre.
Yeah.
Like, that's been, it's been, It showed up in rock and metal. It showed up everywhere. Trap is just popular right now.
Yeah.
Why can you not have a country song that's also trap?
Agree.
Especially because, like, you know, a country rap song, whatever, you have a guy that grew up in the country, grew up in that region, grew up maybe listening to country, and listening to hip hop, and like, I'm going to put them together, and I'm going to do a country rap song.
Yeah.
But the trap beat, okay?
Yeah.
Like, somebody's going to tell him, no, we can't do that.
I know. Not allowed.
So, like, yeah, the more I think about it, the more I'm just like,
music has the rules.
Yeah, it kinda. But yeah, I mean, like, you do have to slot things into charts on Billboard.
Yeah, yeah. That has to be categorized,
And like, and I know there are like, there are textbook definitions for what makes a country song, but it's kinda like, I get the argument now is, does this violate any of that?
Yeah, I don't know. What do you guys think? Do you think it's a country song? Do you think it's a rap song, just a trap song or whatever? I see it says Billboard offers category specific charts simply as a tool for people in the music business to better gauge the success of songs relative to others in a given format.
You are oftentimes faced with difficult categorization choices. So, yeah, this would be one of those. There's paradigm shifts where this kind of stuff gets thrown up in the air, right?
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I don't know. I think this would be a good opportunity to kind of give new looks to the genre. I mean, if nothing else, you're going to get more people into it now.
Sure.
But what we're seeing here, I feel more and more like you're just having some old school folks
country.
That are like, don't mess with our country music.
Maybe,
and
like, you got some purists out there.
Yeah, got some,
in
you,
any genre.
You got them in every genre.
Yeah,
you got purists
there.
That don't want you screwing around, you know?
I know.
And I think it's just a little bit of that.
Yeah. Okay, it's time for the subreddit of the week. And this week is Tip of My Tongue.
Now, tip of my tongue.
I just found this week, and I was like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. So it's something that, of course, is on the tip of your tongue that you can't Google. And every once in a while, you get in this situation and you're like, oh, like, who's that guy who looks like that? This happened to us not too long ago where you were like, there was an actor who looks like so-and-so, and like, you can't really put it together and you don't really know.
I do that all the time,
Google.
Though, because I forget people's names constantly.
He does.
I have this crazy hole in my brain.
Yeah.
It doesn't let me remember names. I remember them, but then like, they're in the periphery. And as soon as I go to focus on to recall it, it's gone.
Yeah.
It's
like, oh,
that's
my
it.
Gosh.
Happens to me all the time.
Oh, my God.
Drives
gosh.
Me nuts.
So I went to the top of all time, and look at this. An animal that looks like a cat wearing a mask. Climbs trees. It's a raccoon.
It's a freaking raccoon.
Raccoon. A stupid, especially, it's called the same thing in my language. So I could see it like a non-native English speaker.
Trees. Oh, my God.
Yeah, right. Can we start a petition to,
No, that would be Trash Panda.
Trash Panda. Yeah. Exactly. So I feel like
Lizzie
we've
calls
all
him
been
Trash Panda.
Trash Pandas. This one cracked me up. What is this? Do-do-do-do-do song.
And it's not Baby Shark.
Right, yeah. I would associate it with sort of a seafaring style, if that makes any sense. It's also pretty fast-paced, with the following taking 4 to 5 seconds to play through. Do, 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 do. How? And then look at that.
Sails Run Pipe.
Did it work? Do, 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 do. Look, it does work. How did they figure that?
I love the first reply to it. Like, how did you? Wait.
Look at that. How? That's pretty good.
Everybody
I like the ship.
That.
I know. But yeah, like, how do you even say, like, how does that go, or what is that song? There was like
I
an
have
app
one.
That you could.
I have one, and I still don't even know how I would even bring it to this.
What you should? What is it?
I think I might. I think I might bring it to. There has been something that has been bugging me on and off for months, for no good apparent reason. It's just, my curiosity is killing me.
What is it?
All right. There was an old video. I remember I went through like a YouTube hole not too long ago. I think I was playing like Dark Souls or something like that. You started pulling stuff up on YouTube.
Yeah.
And like, I found like the Captain Power commercial from like Captain Power toy, like this video. And you put a VHS in and you had this ship and you had to shoot at like it was a light gun. And I had that when I was little. I'm like, oh my God. And that sent me on this like tailspin of things from when I was little that I like to watch. And because I'm watching them again, having not thought about them for decades, and having it all come rushing back, like, oh my God, I remember this. And it was like fun having those epiphanies and aha moments, right? And there's one. Hold on.
Are you all right?
I had a really dry spot back there. It's gone.
Why?
Okay.
Serious.
So there was one video that I like to watch. I remember we pulled up Free to Be You and Me.
Oh,
right?
Free to Be
and watched that. I was like, listen, I used to watch it so many times. I was little Free to Be Your Man. It was great. And it was kind of funny to watch again. And there was another video I watched, and I can't remember what it is. And it's killing me. The only thing I remember from it.
Yeah.
It was one of those things where it's like Free to Be You and Me, which is a series of skits and things of like sections and songs of different kinds, different genres.
And if you know
all
what
piled
this
into
is,
one
put
thing.
In the comments. Yeah.
And all I remember from it was the last section of it, like the last part of it, was this time lapse video of people traveling, getting on buses, really fast time lapse, getting on subway. Like just like a fixed
was
camera,
it a
like people getting on and off. No, it was like time lapse of people getting on and off, buses and trains and subways and planes and stuff like that, and just this person saying the names. There's like a song playing in the background, some instrumental music, and this person narrating, just randomly saying the names of locations. And all I remember is one time I went Kalamazoo, and like that's all I remember because it was the first time I ever heard the word Kalamazoo. I was really little.
It's a funny word.
I thought it was a funny word, so it stuck in my head, and that's the only thing I remember from the whole video. And I can't. I tried like Googling like you know children's videos from the 80s or like because that's when it would have been from, right? And like Kalamazoo time lapse travel, and I could never find it. And I have no idea like where it would even begin. And I'm like, maybe I should bring it to this. Maybe this is the place. Maybe that, because if somebody said do song and they got it, maybe one of these freaking, maybe somebody on this thing could find it.
I think you should do it.
Maybe I should do it.
Yeah, because then it would be like, this weight lifted.
It's not even like I really want to see it. It's just this like small piece of my childhood I'm trying to remember.
Yeah.
That's it. That's all it is. It's pure curiosity.
Isn't that so weird how you just remember things like that that just kind of like pop up?
Or don't remember it.
Yeah, or don't remember. Yeah, that's really crazy. You should definitely try that. Although, I do want to see here real quick, what is the actual word for pasta cake?
Lasagna!
I'll take, I was like, pasta cake? What do you mean pasta cake?
Pasta cake.
Yeah, sometimes you just, you go like, what is that? Like, what is this actor who looks like Michael Douglas but with more hair? Not more dark hair. He's alive, saw him something that can't remember what. He's in his 50s. Here's a mock-up of how he looks. Oh, my God. Really? What?
Did they find out?
Dennis
Boutsikaris?
Oh, wait. Boutsikaris?
It was Dennis Boutsikaris.
Oh!
He does look like Michael Douglas, but with more hair.
He doesn't look like that. That is... I kind of love that, though.
All
oh
right.
My God!
Oh, there you go.
That is really impressive. That's really impressive.
The mock-up is great.
Wow! Who's in Better Call Saul? Really?
Oh!
Oh my gosh!
There you go.
Love it, love it. So that is tip of my tongue. I like it.
All right, it's trailer time.
Oh my gosh! I'm so excited.
The favorite time of the week.
Oh my God!
All right, so here's a big one that came out this week that I've been dying to watch,
and stayed away.
We've waited all the way until this very moment. It's always so hard to do that for this. Sometimes I wish we did this more than once a week.
I know.
But this is for Joker.
Yeah.
Which is it's just the Joker being played by the dude. I can't remember his name because that never happens.
You don't remember Joaquin Phoenix?
Joaquin Phoenix.
Oh.
See, how would I forget Joaquin Phoenix's name?
Oh, how could you forget? After we were talking about Country and Johnny Cash and all that.
I know, all that. But Joaquin Phoenix just poof, went out of my brain.
You know what I read about this Joker that I thought was kind of interesting is that he's like a modern Joker. So he tweets, like he's on social media, all that. Mm-hmm. Don't know how I feel about that.
Well, we haven't seen the teaser trailer yet, so
let's go take a look.
Let's watch it. Here we go.
All right.
Arthur, does it help to have someone to talk to?
Oh, I really like him, though.
My mother always tells me to smile and put on a happy face. She told me I had a purpose. To bring laughter and joy to the world.
Stop them!
Is it just me? Or is it getting crazier out there?
Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile,
Jimmy Durandy.
Even though it's breaking.
He looks
when
so skinny.
In the sky, you'll get by.
What?
If you smile to your fear and sorrow, smile, and maybe tomorrow you'll find a life that's still worthwhile. If you
what's so funny?
Just
freak.
Gotham has lost its way. What kind of coward would do something that cold-blooded? Someone who hides behind a mask.
I used to think that my life was a tragedy. But now I realize it's a comedy.
If you just
whoa!
Holy freaking crap!
Whoa!
Yo, that looks so good! Wow,
whoa.
That is, I don't know what I expected, but I didn't expect that. Wow. So it's a Joker origin story, obviously, but wow. I mean, damn, he looks like he's knocking it out of the park there.
Think so?
Yeah, I think that looks really good.
That is a completely different angle.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know, like this, it might be exactly what's written in DC Comics, right? I don't know really his origin story. Except for, like, you know, that, like, he...
Well, yeah, the whole...
There was an accident.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
You know.
But, wow, he was really skinny.
Yeah, yeah.
He was really, really skinny.
Wow, that looks super good. And now here's a question. Is this going to be a new... I guess they are redoing Batman, aren't they? They're doing him again.
They'd have to do
because Ben Affleck is not going to be Batman anymore.
That's right.
So they're doing it again. Batman. This may be the beginning of a new arc.
Oh my God!
That would be
I can't keep up!
Yeah, but that would be amazing. If this is kind of like the air they're going with, like
yeah.
the vibe they're going with.
Right, right, right.
That I think that's kind of awesome. I think that's
wow.
really cool.
Wow.
And like, there's nothing better than like villains that you could, I mean, one of my favorite things in the world in
yeah.
like, in any movie storytelling, video game storytelling is villains that you can empathize with.
Yeah.
You know, that's,
yeah.
Like when that's done well, boy, does that change everything.
And when they don't do that,
yeah.
it's really
bad.
It's bad.
Yeah, when they're just
yeah.
like, oh, I'm a
when
bad
it's
guy,
just like,
I'm a bad
oh,
guy.
I'm diabolical, just
yeah,
cause.
Blah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but like, but the more they can make you empathize with them.
Yeah.
Because like, if they can straddle that line of having them be unequivocally bad.
Yeah.
They're doing bad things. They need
right.
to stop doing what they're doing. But at the same time, you kind of understand how they got there
right.
and why they might be doing it.
Yeah.
Like, that's kind of the perfect angle to be taking for something like that. That's really great character development. It looks like they are really hitting that just based on the trailer,
yeah.
of course. I mean, we don't know if the movie will be... It's just a trailer.
Yeah, yeah.
Trailers can be like... They could fool you.
That is not at all what I expected.
But that made me really excited for this. Like,
yeah.
that just immediately went to
and
must-see territory
so
for
good.
Me.
He's so good.
Yeah, he's fantastic.
He's so good, Joaquin
yeah.
Phoenix. Wow, that was cool.
Yeah.
That was cool.
All right, and lastly, we got one more.
Oh my God, Game of Thrones!
Game of Thrones Season 8, which is
oh
just
my
about
God.
To start.
I can't.
We're very close.
I don't know
is
what
is it a
I'm
week from
do.
Sunday?
It's a week from Sunday.
As in the day that we're posting this video?
A week, yeah. So as when this goes up, it'll be a week from today. It's
really?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I know.
Like the 14th?
Yeah, 14th, 15th. Yeah.
Oh my God.
I know.
It's just
I
about
can't
to happen.
Even,
I'm so scared.
I am so scared. And it's. I think it's only like 8 episodes. They're all like an hour and a half. There's so much that needs to happen. I feel like so many people are gonna die.
Yeah.
And everybody who is alive right now, I feel like I need to stay alive.
Yeah.
Because I
but
am
they're not going
so
to.
Invested.
They're not going to. And some important people that we really like are definitely going to die. It's just gonna happen. We have to be at terms of that. And we're gonna have to see what they give us,
if
but
something
here
happens to Tyrion.
Well, something will probably happen to Tyrion. Just
oh
just assume everyone's gonna
oh
die.
God. Oh my God.
Start from
I
the position of assuming
it.
They're going to be
okay.
dead, they're not gonna make
oh
it.
God.
That's the only way you're gonna be able to deal with this.
King of the North!
King of the North. Alright.
Jon Snow!
Game of Thrones Season 8 official tease, aftermath. Here we go.
Starks. Winter's here. Yes, yes, yes. better give us some damn information and not just like panning.
It's not going to.
Oh. That's the little hand of the kingpin from Tyrion. Hand of the queen. That Jamie's hand.
Is that Jamie's hand? Oh.
Jon Snow's sword. That better not be it.
That's all we're getting. That's all we're getting.
You asses! Are you kidding me?
April
That's
14th.
All we get?
That's a week from the day that you guys
that
are watching this.
All
if you're watching this on the day
getting?
That we posted.
Wait, did we see this trailer up here?
Yeah, we watched the official trailer.
We did.
We watched it on BS on the internet.
I need more information. This is me clamoring for more information. That told us nothing.
Oh, no, of course it told us nothing.
Unacceptable!
We can't. We just have to. We have to wait.
Aftermath.
We have to wait. It's about to happen. I'm nervous. I'm really nervous. But
they're all going to die, aren't they?
Yeah. It's kind of amazing to me that this show has been to the point where it started from books. And now it's ending before the books.
Right.
Get there.
Yeah.
Before the books catch up. I don't know if that's ever happened before, has
that's
it?
That's a good point.
You know? That's such a strange situation.
Oh my God.
But that makes it all the crazier because up until, like, what was it, last season, everyone who read the books knew what was going to happen.
Even though
there were some departures,
right.
But none of them were, like, really, really, really major. Some of mm-hmm. them, I think, were pretty major, but, mm-hmm. like, the grand, like, line of things happening still was pretty consistent.
Yeah.
Until last season, I think, was the first season that was coming out that the books weren't caught up for.
Right, right.
And now we have the last season, and then nobody knows how this is going to end.
Oh, my gosh.
Nobody really knows.
I can't even...
If you're not directly involved with the movie.
Oh.
It's freaking crazy.
I'm going to be a wreck for the next 2 months. I'm just giving you all a warning. I really am.
Like, how's
I don't know
it actually
going to
wrap
do.
Up? How is this going to wrap up?
I don't know. And I just like, can they all just beat the White Walkers and that'll be it?
And the sun comes
out.
Yay,
and the sun comes out and all the snow melts. Hooray!
Happy.
I know, it's not going to, they're going to devastate us.
Yes,
they're absolutely going to devastate us.
I'm wondering if they're going to go as far as to where like the people just don't win.
Probably, maybe.
Like, that's possible. They could do
that.
They've done so many things in this show that I did not think they would do.
That they wouldn't go there.
Yeah, they wouldn't go there. Like, yeah, but that's not going to happen. And then it happens. So that's not going to happen. Then it happened.
Yeah.
And they do something else they didn't even think of. You'd be like, I can't believe they did that.
Yeah,
over and over and over again. So it would be the biggest freaking, it would be the most Game of Thrones thing ever.
It would.
To have them just actually lose.
You know,
at the end of the whole thing and not actually come out on top.
I remember like a couple seasons ago, there was an interview with George R. R. Martin that I think about all the time. And they said like, do you know how this is going to end? And he went like, well, you know, maybe, maybe not. Maybe I'll just have the last scene of the whole thing be snow blowing across the graves of all your favorite people. And that'll be it. And you'll see the names on all of their headstones.
Yeah.
And that'll be it.
Yeah.
And I was like, he's going to do that, isn't he?
he's going to do it. He's going to kill
that's
everybody.
That's what it's going to be. And it's just,
the White Walker's going to win. That's it.
I cannot. I can't. I'm not ready. I'm not ready.
All right. Well, next week. Okay, guys. So that was this episode of BS on the Internet.
Woo!
Rumor has it there's another week next week.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Oh, my gosh. And it's my birthday this week.
And it's Lissy's birthday this week.
On Tuesday. So we're going to be streaming on Tuesday.
Yes.
Because I want to spend my birthday with you guys.
That's right.
And we always do that on our birthdays. And I love streaming with you guys and everything. You guys are so awesome and family and all that kind of good stuff. So if you could stop by on Tuesday,
yes,
that would be great.
That'd be great.
And we'll have some cake.
We'll have some cake.
Yeah, so it'll probably be between 9:30 and 10 Eastern Standard on
to start,
Twitch.
Yeah.
Usually, I don't know what we're gonna play yet though.
Yeah, we'll figure that out.
Maybe we'll just look at puppies.
Maybe we'll just look at puppies.
And the mums, and we'll talk about food.
I'm sure that some of that'll happen, but they're probably in the company of something else that we need recovery from to get
birthday.
To the puppies. That's usually the way that works.
It's my birthday, I get to pay.
Right. Well, if you want to learn anything more about what we talked about today, links are in the description.
Yes.
And don't forget to watch us on Twitch. Oh!
What the hell was that?
And if you like this video,
yes,
please support us on Patreon. Click like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you tomorrow. Thanks, bye.
Bye.